Hello there and good evening. This is Ruth Pozuelo from Curval.com, and today I have a very special treat for you. If you are working with Google Analytics and doing a lot of Google Analytics reports, you'll probably find yourself doing the same things all over, like creating a calendar, creating a location table, and it's like you have to repeat yourself just to be able to do like basic analysis. So what I have done is I have created a template for every new Google Analytics report, and that template includes a calendar, a location table, and removes spam, refer spam. So instead of opening a new Power BI, you just open that and then you're good to go basically. So I'm going to show you how it looks like. Here is the template. And this is what it's going to ask you when you open it. It will ask you about your Google Analytics account. And I have configured this parameter as a list. So if you have more than one account, you can actually specify it in the parameter, and then you can just configure that right off the bat. So you have the Google Analytics account, Google Analytics property, Google Analytics view, and then it will ask you about the year, the month, and the day for the date calendar that you wanted to start with. It will ask you about the language for the calendar. You can choose from the list or add the new ones to the list, new languages. And then you can configure even if you want to the start. If your calendar starts on Monday or on Sunday. So like it says here, Monday select one, otherwise select zero. So once you've done that, you have to make sure that these three are relevant. You just click on load, and it will load a calendar, a location table, and I have also a date and sessions. And this is just because I want to have the relationships already configured too. Let me show you how it looks like behind the scenes. If you click on edit query, you will see here is the date calendar. And here you have the parameters. So if you click on manage parameters, you will be able to change all the parameters that you like, okay? And even these descriptions. So you can adapt to your parameters. Here is in the list where you write the account ID or name. You know, sometimes Power BI uses account name and sometimes account ID. You have to test first to know which one to use. You can add both and then, choose whatever is relevant. If you don't know where to find it, here is a link to a blog post to actually see where those IDs and names are in Google Analytics. And here's where you can change the year, the month, the day, the language, and if your week starts on Monday or on Sunday. So you have these, you have the location table, and here the city ID is the key. So if you are going to get another tables from Google Analytics, you have to download city ID to be able to get continent, country, etc. from this table, okay? That is the lowest level that we can go. You have also, I've had done a video on this on how to remove refer spam. And there is this guy's referramspamblocker.com that they have been kind enough to provide their blacklist as a table so we can pick it up. So every time they update their referramspam table, when you click refresh here, you will get the latest. So this is a really, really cool feature actually. You can, of course, use their service to remove the spam directly from Google Analytics, but sometimes, you know, it just leaks, so you still need to do it both ways. So I have the spam list, and then I have this date, city ID, source, and sessions. And in this table, I have already removed the refer spam. You can see here I have done the merged and excluded all the spam, and then remove the column because we don't really need them, and then change the types so it is okay. And if we click close and apply, as I explained before, you will have, you know, the relationships between your data, your table, and your location table, everything configured already from the start. So, I mean, this will save you tons and tons and tons of time. It has saved me tons of times. And then if you use other type of, you know, like standard reports, you can actually add them to these. So this is like, you know, the really, let's start from scratch. So it will save you tons of time. You can go here to edit parameters and then easily change it to another account, another property, and another view. Click OK and it will load that data. I mean, it's so cool. Now, I don't think I have chosen anything relevant, but I really, really hope you enjoy this. You can download the Power BI file in our curval.com site. So with that said, I hope you enjoy the video, and I really, really hope you will enjoy also the Power BI template. It's extremely useful. If you like this video, please let me know. If you have questions, you can either comment, or you can contact me through my website. You have all the links that you need in the description box. And please subscribe. I publish around a video a week, more or less. Have a nice evening. Bye.